Sherri Rasmussen, a 29-year-old nurse and newlywed 3 months into her marriage, was enjoying life and looking forward to what it would bring. Tragically, it was cut short on February 24, 1986, when she was fatally shot in her Van Nuys, California condo. Her body was found around 6 p.m. by her husband, John Rutten, who'd just come home from work. Sherri was shot in the chest and there was significant trauma to her face, Shannon Presby, a head deputy district attorney for the Los Angeles County DA's office, told the head injuries indicated that she had been hit with a hard object numerous times, added Presby. There were no signs of a forced entry, but a broken ceramic vase and scattered papers indicated a struggle occurred, according to Mark Safarik, a retired FBI criminal profiler. In addition, the victim's BMW was missing. Was this a burglary gone wrong? Officials observed that Rasmussen had two broken fingernails and a bite mark on her arm. The bite was swabbed and collected as evidence. Rasmussen's family and friends described her as a very smart and very caring person who always looked out for others. Investigators learned that Rutten, an engineer, and Rasmussen dated for a year before tying the knot. Detectives began their investigation by interviewing Rutten. He left for work at 7:20 a.m. Coworkers confirmed he was at the office all day. Rutten was essentially cleared, investigators said. Neighbors told police that they'd seen Rasmussen's garage door closed at 8:30 a.m. It was open at 9:30 a.m. and her BMW was gone. Investigators believe the murder happened between 8:30 a.m. and 9:30 a.m. Detectives asked Rasmussen's parents if their daughter had any enemies. They stated that she had had an altercation with one of Rutten's former girlfriends, but they didn't know her name. Rutten told investigators that he'd casually dated a woman when he was in college at UCLA. He said he didn't believe she'd have any reason to harm his wife, according to Presby. Investigators returned to their original theory of a botched robbery. The autopsy report revealed that Rasmussen had been shot 3 times by a .38 caliber firearm. An injury to Rasmussen's forehead appeared to have been made by the barrel of a revolver, according to Safarik. After 2 weeks with no new leads, Rasmussen's car was found in a residential area a few miles from the victim's home. The car was unlocked and the keys were in the ignition, said Presby. The car was processed, but there weren't any fingerprints or anything of evidentiary value. 5 weeks later, investigators thought they caught a break. Two armed individuals broke into a nearby residence where they found the owner at home. They had a handgun, but they didn't use it. Instead, they fled the scene, according to Safarik. Investigators considered that the same pair could have killed Rasmussen. The victim described the home invaders as Hispanic and in their early 20s. A sketch was made, but no new leads turned up. 3 months after the murder, Rutten left Los Angeles. The case continued to grow colder.